I know this is your first year here, but can you talk about the energy that this team has going into the Civil War?
Well, we have great energy. I mean, this is one of the great rivalries in all of sports. I just get chills just thinking about being part of it. And just to hear some of the guys that have been part of it over the years that are here and talk about the memories and every one of the details that they can explain is really something special.
Let's break down the Duck defense for a second. First with the secondary, when you have a guy like Ifo back there, I mean, what's your game plan for stopping him?
We have a lot of respect for them in their secondary. They got good players. They got good safeties. They got good corners. It's a fast, athletic group. But we're going to challenge them. We're going to make them play. We're going to make them play corner and do their job. So that's what you do against good teams is you make them play their coverages. And so that's our plan.
With a lack of depth at running back, I mean, what adjustments do you have to make with a strong Duck line?
Well, it's just the next man in. You know, fortunately, Chris Brassfield and the guys are really prepared. So with Teron out, Storm's got to shoulder the load. And then we have Damian, and then contingency plan after that if we lose two more. So it's just the next man up. And fortunately, they have been prepared, and I ask them all the time, you're a sprained ankle away from 40 plays, so you better be ready. So they have the mentality that they're going to be ready if they're called on.
You mentioned the secondary a second ago, but can you talk about the matchup that these receivers are going to see against those guys?
Well, it's always a challenge. It's a fast, athletic group, you know, they're going to have to win at the line of scrimmage when they play press. They're going to have to fight to get by them on deep balls. And they're really going to have to transition well out of their breaks to gain separation. So they're poised and ready to do it, and it'll be a heck of a matchup.
Even with, you know, Storm Ward's kind of 50-50, Teron and Chris Brown out for the season, do you think this offense can find balance against Oregon?
Oh, sure. I mean, that's the goal every week is we want to throw it well, we want to run it well, and then you react to the events of the game. They're going to have to stop the run. They're going to have to stop the pass. And, you know, we're going to try to find some things formationally to create some advantages for us.
Sean's last game, have you talked with him at all about that?
I haven't. I've thought about it. It's just, it's the, hopefully not the end of a great career. Knowing him, he's not thinking about that. He's thinking about the next play, being really prepared for everything that Oregon has, and that's his mentality. He's got a football game, first things first, and he's going to be ready.
Finally, because it is Thanksgiving tomorrow, what are you thankful for?
Oh, I have thankful for my Lord and Savior, for all the blessings in my life. I have a wonderful family. In fact, they're here visiting here now because we've been they've been back home in Florida. So I just want to thank you. God for my wonderful wife, Honor, and my four wonderful children, John, Honor, Olivia, and Caroline, and for this wonderful community here at Oregon State. Coach Riley sets the pace. Really appreciate him and all the coaches and these great players who have just made it really a great year for me.